Married people of Reddit, what are the little things that keep your marriage healthy? We both agree that whenever we start to have an argument to do a gut check, that is, check if either one of us is hungry. If so, end the argument immediately, eat something, and wait half an hour to see if we want to resume arguing. We now argue about twice a year. I'm one of those people that absolutely suck at knowing what to say when trying to comfort someone, and I'll always wind up saying something that just makes it worse. I think the best relationship advice I have ever received is that you don't have to always verbally comfort them, and you can still let them know you care by just being there, 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 just being there. Miso is terrible at this too, but he just lets me cry on his shoulder while not saying anything. And it's much better than comfort words that don't mean anything. Arguments. More specifically, not bottling things up. If I'm being in butthole, my wife will tell me, there's no need to yell at each other, but sort crap out. Leg rubs after a long day, cooking for them on their day off, surprising them with flowers even when it's not a holiday or birthday, buying them something when you buy something for yourself. Treating her possessions with the same care as if they were my own. Date nights. Telling her I love her and kissing her each day. Complimenting her after a workout or when she does something to her hair. Anytime she does something to show herself off a bit. Letting her know when I'm upset so that she doesn't have to guess and we can talk about it. Never going to bed mad at one another. Sometimes apologizing even when I think I'm right. Apologizing for hurting her feelings even if it was unintentional. I love my wife. I enjoy threads like this for reminding me how lucky I am to have someone like her. Thanks, OP. Giving each other personal space but expressing our love for each other every chance we get. There have been many days where we'll find ourselves busy, but one will always come to the other at some point to say we haven't looked at the other enough. We'll hold each other, look at each other for a few minutes, just being present with other and tell each other we're madly in love with the other and kiss. We're also open with each other and tackle problems as a team. Neither of us ever set out to win an argument. It's always us versus the issue. We never go to bed angry if we do argue, and to be honest, that's rare. Also, we keep things fresh and exciting in the bedroom. In short, we've been married 14 years but we've never once stopped dating each other. Because of that, the spark we initially felt when we first met has never left, never diminished, but it's gotten much, much stronger and richer. Couldn't agree more. The team bitterness versus the issue is so important. He has an alarm that goes off at 9:15 every night that he calls his Bumble Daisy alarm. He stops whatever he is doing, sings a little song, and then asks me if he can do anything for me. Most of the time I just want a hug and a kiss. We make each other laugh, a tickle, sharing a joke or a silly gif, or just being goofy, especially nothing that's particularly funny to other people, but little things that are silly to us. I think it makes us truly happy around each other, and if one of us is having a bad day or we're at the end of an argument, a smile or a chuckle goes a long way in shaking off those moments. Like, the bad days are still bad and hurt feelings are still hurt, but that smile or chuckle reminded us that there's good out there and that we're there for each other. This is a big one for me. Whenever my wife talks about me in front of other people, she always, always says the absolute best things about me, even though I give her plenty to complain about. She even does it when I'm not around, since friends mention my wife said this or that. All of our friends think I'm a rockstar husband and father, and I think this is largely due to me fitting the role she made for me. She wins me respect from others just by speaking good things about me. Also, talk about everything. I tell her how much I appreciate her respect and ask her how I can return the love. When I find myself feeling frustrated with her for silly things at home, I've started to recognize it's just that I'm in a bad mood, and I get out of it by telling her how beautiful she is. Don't just say she's beautiful, guys. That's lazy. Say, wow, I just noticed how beautiful your freckles look today, and give her a big hug and tell her what she's done recently that I appreciate. Oh, and go on dates even when you don't feel like it, especially when you have kids. It can seem impractical to get a babysitter when both of you are tired, but just go and admit how you're feeling. Laugh about the craziness of parenting and then just have fun. Crap, last one. Bedroom time. Guys, never, ever, ever pressure your wife to make things happen in bed. It is your responsibility to bring her to a place where she's ready for it. If she says, "Sweetie, I just don't think I'm up for it," be a big man and say, "I understand. Can I just hold you until we fall asleep?" Then it builds trust. Sex has to be about closeness and not lust for it to really work in marriage. Apologize like a Canadian when you mess up. Instructions unclear. Poured maple syrup on wife. He helps with everything around the house. Laundry, dishes, cleaning. Our daughter, I help with everything outside the house. Mow, trim, move heavy crap. Car maintenance, etc. There is no his and hers chores. We all live under the same roof. We're all into taking care of it together. We also power lift together. He spots me, I spot him. We cheer each other on and help each other reach goals. The encouragement goes outside the gym and really makes us a solid team. He's truly my best buddy. Apologize. Seriously, if you say something mean, which you will, just apologize for it after things calm down. It goes a long way. As a Canadian with a Canadian girlfriend, sometimes determining who is more sorry can get a little competitive. Ladies and gentlemen, please cook for your husbands and your wives at the end of a grueling day of work at least once per 2 weeks. It will literally make their day better. Don't be afraid to. Seriously, go for it. Nothing makes someone feel better when they get a home-cooked meal. If you have a problem, talk about it. Always go from the perspective of working things out. Sounds simple, but lots of people come from the perspective of keeping score. None of this, oh, he didn't take out the garbage like he said he would. I'll only hang up my shirts and not his type of nonsense. Stop and think, was it an extra busy day so he forgot? Is he not feeling well if a guy is thinking she's nagging me about something he can't retreat? He has to think. Is she nervous because her mom is coming over or whatever? Just think through the whole situation. Usually people don't do things to be obnoxious. And if they are, you don't need to be married to them. Which brings me to the most important point, albeit not a little thing. Marry the right person in the first place. If you don't have anything in common, or aren't nice people to each other, all the little things in the world aren't going to help. A love note on the bathroom mirror doesn't make up for someone you're unable to have a conversation with. Well said. I especially like the last part. It's easy to mistake romance for love. Communication and understanding. Also do little things for the other person. My girlfriend, been dating 10 plus years, not married by choice, neither of us are religious and we don't care. Loves coffee. I hate it, but whatever. I notice her coffee pot is running out of water in the reservoir, I'll fill it up for her, or I'll fill her bowl full of sugar cubes back up again when I notice it's low. I also just randomly text her I love you. My husband hates chocolate and peanuts, but he buys them for me anyway. Being able to take the pee out of each other. Being able to argue and let it go. Arguing and then cracking a joke almost instantly afterwards and returning to normal. Being able to laugh in an argument is huge for us. You have to keep working on it. Saying you love them every day. Being there when they need you. Asking how their day was. Being interested in what happens. Having a date night every so often. Cuddling. It's actually the little things that keep a marriage healthy. If you slack on the little things, it doesn't matter what the big picture is. Those little things will start grinding. I got advice a while back to never stop dating. We try to keep it consistent and go on a date once a month. Sure, we go out to eat often and do other things here and there, but on our date night is special. Each month we rotate who plans a dinner activity. It's really nice because I get to make her feel special and cared about. That's what matters most. We all get busy with work, kids, hobbies, family, etc. It's important to carve out time to maintain your relationship. Don't engage in the "my spouse is terrible because" conversations. That can start an internal dialogue it's hard to back away from. Do pick a regular spot for dinner, breakfast, whatever, and make it a ritual. That place becomes your personal Switzerland, where even if you've both had a rough week, the ritual of going there will break the ice. My wife and I have eaten at the same Mexican place just about every Friday for 15 years. We hardly ever took a kid with us. I've got a buddy and he and his wife get up every Sunday and go to Waffle House at like 8 a.m. before the church crowd hits, and they've done this for more than 25 years. It requires work and effort. I always love my wife, but occasionally I don't like her for some stupid reason. If you married them for healthy reasons, you love them. If you are mad about something, stressed, not being intimate etc, it can be easy to think that the love is gone. It's not. You are just struggling. A few years ago there was a TV show where a marriage counselor would work with couples who were struggling, and one of the tools she used was to try and get them to have sex for 30 days straight. It worked. A lot of people I've watched let their marriages fail will tell me they wish they'd try harder to hang on to it. This only applies with two healthy people. Addiction, infidelity or abuse void these principles immediately. Not married, 8-year long-term relationship, but doing something your partner values. I give my boyfriend long massages and he loves it so much that, if he were going to break up with me, he would have to debate whether or not it was worth losing the massages. Gratitude. My husband and I say thank you not just for the big stuff but also the little things, like running a chore or making dinner, and we are both incredibly grateful to be loved by the other. We're each other's biggest fans and supporters. It's us against the world, and that helps us get over the petty crap. Yes, this is key. My husband thanks me for every meal I cook, every load of laundry I do, and makes the kids be thankful too. It's such a huge thing to know you are appreciated. It makes the difference between happily wanting to spoil your partner and resentment. Make divorce not an option. My wife and I don't use the word in our house. When we know that the other is in it for good, it creates the safety needed to be yourself. The other little thing is honesty. I have had times where I was afraid to be honest with my wife, but even if it causes conflict, knowing that she knows me fully and that she knows that I am completely open with her is a very intimate thing. Be completely honest, nothing hidden. Okay, one more. Being okay with conflict. One big lie I used to believe is that a lot of conflict meant that you weren't healthy maritally. I don't think anyone ever gets to the point where they have no more conflict because they have solved it all. A better goal to shoot for is still staying connected even while there is unresolved conflict. Can you still love him while you don't understand why they do the things they do and even while you're pee off? That is maturity right there. And being respectful during the conflicts. I'm not going to shred your character just because I'm upset and hurt. I've only been married for 316 days but have been with my husband for almost 6 years and we've known each other for about 13 years. Here are my tips. 1. Before we got engaged we went through an awful financial issue and not once did we ever blame the other person for our situation. With us, it is always us versus the world. We are a team and every victory and every defeat is shared. 2. That classic Ogden Nash quote is a classic for a reason. To keep your marriage brimming with love in the loving cup. Whenever you're wrong, admit it. Whenever you're right, shut up. 3. Laughter. The only reason I considered marrying him was because he is the only person who can manage to make me laugh even when I'm angry at him. We constantly sing nonsensical songs to each other and have the same non-sequitur sense of humor. I'm not against marriage, but I never had any interest in it, didn't see the point. 4. Affection. Don't get lazy. Let them know you like what you see when they're changing. Grab butts. Touch hands. McKibbert. I've had friends tell me how nice it is to know a couple like us because we're constantly having some form of physical contact. We're not like slobbering all over each other but IDGAF about grabbing his butt in public or wrapping my arms around him. 5. Thoughtfulness and praise. We constantly tell each other how rad we think the other is. I praise his work ethic and wit and he tells me I'm one of the smartest people he knows. We genuinely like and admire each other so it makes the idea of touching butts forever seem like the prize it is. We think of the other, even if it's just me ordering a snack he likes in my next Amazon order or him stopping at a store to pick up some ingredient I mentioned I needed offhandedly. We are always on the lookout for ways to improve each other's lives. In conclusion, I've always hated when people say that marriage is hard work. Because it's not. It's not work. It's not hard. Life is hard. The things life throws at you are hard. Debt. Illness. Misfortune. Being married to someone with the best butt I've ever seen who makes me laugh every day is the easy part. It's the part of my life that makes all the hard stuff bearable. Working every day to keep that love going isn't work. We go to bed mad. Usually wake up not mad anymore. Staying up to fight when you're tired and not feeling the love isn't productive. If you're still mad in the morning, you can talk then. My parents always told me never to sleep on an argument. You never know if you'll wake up the next day to resolve it. Find shared interests and find separate interests. I am a gamer, my wife is not, but we moved the computer into the living room so she can watch TV and read while I am gaming. She loves hearing the interactions I have online. We both really enjoy the craft beer scene and love sci-fi and action movies and the same TV shows, so we have things to do together, yet I game separately. Also, I play guitar, so when I go into my music room to play, she throws on headphones and plays things on her iPad, or she often listens and gives my critiques, which since I suck, it's nice having a positive person around. Second biggest thing, and it's an old cliche, never go to bed mad. Resolve the issues you can. Don't let them drag out overnight. Give in even if you're sure she is wrong. Be the peacemaker, not the grudge holder. Also, it's the little things you develop together. We have a saying at Go Team, our last name. We use this whenever we maybe score something at a great price or we pay off a bill, etc. We fist bump and say Go Team, last name. It just helps us be one unit instead of two people. We will be married 20 years this April and we met on AOL back in 1994. Nice that you guys can compromise so well. I think that's really important in any relationship. I also wholeheartedly agree with your second point. Bad mad is a shithole. Don't go there. I've seen so many negative comments here on Reddit about couples who babba talk, but it's always worked and continues to work for me and my husband. We've been married a decade and have been told by different people that we still act like we're newlyweds. We are religiously committed to having a date night every week. Nothing extravagant ever really. We have a rule that we're not allowed to use our phones during the date unless it's to show the other something funny or cool we saw on the internet earlier. Easy, selflessness. Be selfless, not to the point where you are unhappy. However, try your hardest to be selfless as opposed to selfish. Selfishness can hurt a good relationship. Screwing your wife as if you were still single and dating. That mentality of I am going to take what I can get while I am here because this may not be here in the morning. Also, foreplay and oral sex. Neither of these should stop or be significantly limited just because you got married. Communication. If something about your so annoys you, come right out and say so instead of bottling it up. Having constructive arguments is hard enough even without anger about something that happened a year ago randomly thrown in. Also, if your so does something you find amazing, tell them. If they do something for you, thank them. It shows that you are aware of what they're doing for you, and that you value them as a person. It's the all about the small things like listening and paying attention to each other. Partners are supposed to bring out the best in each other, after all. Little gifts just to let them know you were thinking about them during a trivial moment like grocery shopping. Even if it's just a small chocolate, it makes a huge difference. Other little acts of service like making tea or coffee for the other one. I set a Google reminder once per week to do something nice for my wife and a reminder once per month to do a self-assessment that I'm being fair, honest, and appreciative. I'm a divorce lawyer. I don't have any special insights, but the worst parts of our marriage have been when I wasn't being fair, when one of us wasn't being forthright, or too many instances of unappreciation had accrued. Not all of those things at once necessarily, but any of them led to strife. Taking time to make sure I'm treating her the way I want her to be treated, the way I expect my brothers-in-law to treat my sisters, pays dividends that I can't quantify. We say I love you multiple times a day. We give little kisses randomly as well as every time one of us leaves the house. We say thank you to each other all the time and acknowledge when the other one does something around the house. We send random messages with emoji hearts just to say I'm thinking of you. It's so nice. It's always extremely weird to me when I hear couples say that they stopped saying I love you or they don't thank their partner for just being them. I have no idea how that could happen and couldn't imagine not saying those things to my partner every day. We also learned our love languages and surprise each other with little actions that we know the other will like and be super grateful for. For example, my husband is a doer and he's very domestic. He does a lot of things around the house. So along with using my own love language, verbal acknowledgement, I do small things for him that are usually classified as his chore. For example, bringing in the garbage cans on Wednesdays since he put them out in the morning, or picking up the pet food because that's something he usually does, or going the extra mile and doing all the pet things before he gets home. He knows I'm a verbal and public praise lover, so he will randomly make Instagram posts about how much he loves me or sends me flowers or something. Also, we genuinely just like each other. He's my favorite person and we often tell each other that we love just hanging out at home doing nothing. We have our cute inside jokes. We point it out when we feel the same way about something because it's a reminder that we're on the same page. We have arguments sometimes, sure, but we value our harmony more than anything. We just love us. TLDR. Be thankful for your partner. Tell them thank you and I love you often. Give them kisses. Laugh. And remember every day why you like them too. And hold hands when you go to sleep. I have been married 7 years now. I think one of the absolute best things is that both of us don't want it to end. We mutually hate new dating and we are each other's best friends. All the stress, pain, life taking a big old dump on the marriage can all be overcome by both people simply wanting it to. Every couple is going to be a little different. I have many married couples as friends and all of them could draw a line on my wife or myself and say that crap wouldn't fly if we were married. My marriage is good because we both value the same things in life and we seem to not care about a lot of the same things. My wife and I also have great communication. She trusts me to handle the finances so we never have to stress about money. If there is a purchase we can't afford, she trusts my judgment when I say we can't do it. So, in general terms, trust and communication. The 5-year-5-second rule has worked well for us. If something isn't going to matter in 5 years, it shouldn't matter for more than 5 seconds. Trust. My wife is out to 3 a.m. with friends. It never bothers me. I get hit on by intern at work. She teases me about it. Trust. If we are at a restaurant, I offer her the first bite of whatever I eat, and then after to switch if she likes it. Doesn't matter what she orders. I want her to know her happiness is important, even in something as small as a meal. Little jokes and secrets. We have 2 little kids, so it's hard to have quality time together sometimes. But it's the little things that make me feel most connected to him. The funny text, the hidden joke, the silly thing we'll say or do to each other in a discreet way. I made him a pancake with a hidden dick butt on one side a few days ago, so the kids didn't know. Ha ha ha. He got a kick out of that. The kids didn't know why we thought pancakes were so funny that morning. It's stuff like that that makes me feel like even if the kids and jobs monopolize a lot of our time, we still have these secret moments just between us to bond over and laugh together. Never go to bed angry. Laugh. A lot. Make things fun. Accept that it's possible you're wrong. Touch each other, outside of sex. Do things together, no matter how small. Take them on dates, no matter how small. Source. Married for 29 years. Actually being brave enough to have the argument or difficult discussion when you need to. Crappy days and moods happen and sometimes the air just needs to be cleared. But never stooping to crappy levels during it, that is. No name calling or cruelty, you cannot put that crap back in the tube. Even when my husband is driving me insane and I cannot fathom his thought process on something and every inch of me wants to scream at him until he sees the light, I still fully respect him as a person and want the best for him and us. I can't imagine my life without him in it. I mean, it would be tidier. But apart from that. 30 years old here and have been married for 7 years and together for 16 years. So I am not sure if this is a little thing, but I say find a hobby that both of you'll really like. It opens the doors for years of communication and fun chats. My wife and I are gamers, so we have years of stuff to talk about it. Saying you're sorry and explaining why you were upset. Not an excuse to do something mean, but if you lash out because there's something underneath your anger, take a few minutes and figure out the root of the problem. Then after you've calmed down, go back, apologize and explain why you were upset. I hear of so many marriages ending because of bad communication, and it all starts when you stop telling each other what's wrong and start building a relationship from being passive aggressive to one another. One day, that wall will be too large to even chisel away at and the love that lies at the foundation will be gone. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.